In many PhD disciplines, students need to generate some data sets to perform some analysis in order to get answers to their research questions or to get an evidence for the hypothesis or whatever is their point of view. In most cases, these data sets are generated by using surveys. However, a large amount of data sets are already available on government websites, which students can use freely because in most cases they have a Creative Commons license. Almost all developed countries have these types of websites where data sets are available, and some of the developing countries also have these websites. In this video, I'm going to show you some of the websites for Australia and US where you can get free data sets to do some analysis for your research. And stick around till the end of this video, because at the end I will show you some of the fastest growing occupations, not based on my own opinion, but based on the data which we will get from a US government website. And we are starting right after this short break. Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Tahir, and if this is your first time, please hit the subscribe button and also the notification bell to get notified whenever I post a new video on this channel every Tuesday and Friday. So before I show you the datasets websites, it is important for you to understand few things. First of all, most organizations, they are working on the FAIR principles of data. And what are FAIR principles of data? In this FAIR principle, F stands for findable, A for accessible, I for interoperable, and R for reusable. So I want to explain these terms and few more before I show you the dataset websites, because some of you might be interested in knowing how this works. So when we say data should be findable, it means that these datasets must have some DOI or digital object identifier, similar to journal papers or articles. They have a DOI as well. By using this DOI, anyone can find this data set and use it. And when we say accessible, it not necessarily means that all data should be open to everyone, because there are some privacy and security concerns, and some government organizations may restrict the access of the data. But if you know that data is available, you can get hold of that data by using some of their procedures. And in Australia, all of the government agencies, they have to put all non-sensitive data as open data on government website, and I'm going to show you in a minute. And when we say interoperable, it means that the formats which we are going to use should be a community agreed format. For example, some data sets have CSV format, some has Excel format or PDF format or some other JSON or other formats. So all these formats are acceptable community formats, so everybody can use it on various operating systems. And when we say reusable, so it means that this data must have some metadata which links it to some contextual information, and we must understand what are the context in which this data was collected. And here I want to mention a very important thing is that sometimes students are struggling to find how we can make some questions for our questionnaire. The good thing is that some of this data also shows you some of the questions for your research. So what are the good questions for a particular data which have been used by previous researchers? So you can follow their path and you can select some of the questions for your own research and use them in your own questionnaires. I have a separate video about questionnaires which you can find on my channel, how to make a research questionnaire, something like that. You can search and you can find. So this was the FAIR principle. And now one further detail I would like to mention here for ODI. There is an organization which is called doi.org, and if you look at their website, there is a tab for registration agencies, and you should be aware of these agencies because these are the agencies which allot or which register this digital object identifier for any data set. Another thing which I would like to mention here is that in this video, I am going to show you websites where you can get data mostly for social sciences, where you can get data for population, geography, economics, and these kind of things. For technical or for engineering data sets, I will make a separate video. where I will discuss about machine learning repository, UCIR, for example, Reddish, there is a robotics repository. So if some of you are engineering students, please let me know and put something in the comments about your discipline, and I will make a separate video for engineering students. Another thing is, if for example you are looking for some data for your own specific country, not for US or Australia, you should search for similar websites for your own country, and definitely you will get some websites from where you will be able to get some data. Now I will jump on my computer and I will show you the largest government websites of Australia and US. The first website which I would like to show you is Australian government website, data.gov.au. This is the largest source of open data from Australian government. So these are free data sets available here, and anyone can access this data. And this data has a lot of value for growing the economy of the country. And this is the purpose why government agencies put the data on these websites, so that everyone would be able to contribute to the economy of the country. And if you click on this data sets, you have a lot of filtering options here. As you can see that if I click, for example, any location, I can select any particular state of Australia. I also have the ability to select any of these formats available, HTML, PDF format, and then there are some Excel formats available, and TIFF format for imaging, and some other formats are also available. So very easy to use website, and you can also select any dates from 1492 to today's date. So you can just put the starting year here and the last year in this column. So very intuitive website, and I hope that you would be able to use these public data sets. And the next website is Australian National Data Service. And this website is developed by four partners. And if you click on this About Us and About Us Home, these are the four institutions: Monash University, Australian National University, Commonwealth Scientific and Industrial Research Organization, and Australian Government, or National Research Infrastructure for Australia. And here they describe the core purpose of this organization: to make Australia's research data assets more valuable for researchers, research institutions, and the nation. And to explore this website, your starting point should be this tab, Working with Data. And these are the FAIR data principles, which I have mentioned earlier. You can read about them further. And then you click on these Guides and Resources and Guides and Resources homepage, and you will find a section Getting Started. So this should be your starting point. And I hope again that as a PhD research student, you should be able to explore this website and get some useful data for your research. And this is an example data from Australian National University. Here you have to get an account with them. But anyway, I just wanted to show you the digital object identifier. This is the value of DOI for this dataset. And if you have this value, you can search it on the internet. And this data has a lot of information. Before getting the data files, you can have a look that whether this data will be useful for you or your project or not. And then you can create an account and get these files. The next website is Australian Bureau of Statistics, abs.gov.au. And this website also has a lot of statistical data. So if you click on the statistics, you will come to this page. And as you can see that economy data, data about population, health data, industrial data, labor data, and a lot of other data types also available, including the micro data. And you can also have some guidelines about methodology and standards. And here you can browse by using the catalog number once you have these, or you can also browse by release date if you have some clue about the period of the data. So another very useful website. I encourage you to explore this website as well. Now, probably the largest data website for US is census.gov. This is a department which does not only count the population of United States, they also have a huge amount of data for US. And in order to access that data, you need to type a subdomain, which is data.census.gov. And here you can read about this website if you want further information. Otherwise, if you scroll down, you have all this data available. There is also an advanced search option, which you can access by clicking here. So let me click on this population data. And let's say we want this employment data. And as you can see that there are a lot of tables, 683 tables here. If I click on this, now this table is available. So in order to download this data, you have to click on customize table. Then there is a download link. If you click here, then you can select if multiple years are available. Sometimes you will see a lot of years here, but this data is only for 2017, and the format available is only CSV. PDF is not clickable, so PDF is not available for this data. And then if you click on download, you can simply download this data. So just click on download now and it will be downloaded. So I just cancel this. So this is the largest website in US. And now at the end, I would like to show you Bureau of Labor Statistics. This is BLS.gov. This is also US official website. And there is some interesting data available here for you. So if I click on this data tools, you have various data retrieval options here, customized tables, and some of their publications are very useful. And one of those is this occupational Outlook handbook. If I click on that, here you can have some very useful information as a student. So you can see what are the fastest growing occupations. And if I click here, I will see this chart, and this shows that this occupation is having a growth rate of 63%. If you are working in any closely associated field, you might think going to this profession later on once you finish your studies. And here you can have all these occupations which are growing fast, and you might select one for yourself. And as you can see that this data is quite recent. So there are large number of other websites available where you can get public data sets for free. But this was just the first introductory video, and some of you will start using some data sets. And if you have any questions, please put in the comments, and I will make some more videos on this topic later on. So I hope that you like this video. If so, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. See you next time.